us direction from above. We need a word.
Because I have coffee in other places. This word ain't coffee.
From just one word. From
but when I drink my coffee, I want it to be hot.
And cause a sun.
I want it to be hot. Just hot enough not to burn my tongue. That's kind of hot. I want it. I put it in the microwave and warm it up for a minute. That's how hot I like it. But if it's lukewarm, man, that ruins my day. I like it. I only want to do one thing. One thing I look forward to is my cup of coffee and lukewarm. That's what Christians are when they pray. When they don't pray, they look warm. You don't know what you're gonna get from them. 1 minute it's hallelujah, in a hall. The next minute, blankety blank, 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 blank. That's a lukewarm Christian. In the mental profession, they call it bipolar. He got some spiritually bipolar people. We don't know what you don't know what you're gonna get when you talk to me. That's Christians that don't pray. Mm. That's why you have to do that you have to do level one, pray for your personal appeals, level two.
Arbitration agreement.
And then level three, you have agreement. And that's what Wednesday night should be about, is prayer of agreement. Every great revival that has broken out started from a prayer meeting.
That's right. That's right.
Most people are very... You need to study your history on great revivals. Most of the time it wasn't the preaching. Most of the time it wasn't the singing. It was the praying. Yeah, that's a book many of you have read.
Chains opened up in
probably
prayer.
Read before, called Fresh Winds, Fresh Fire. Mm. Book where this man went to a church and it was a dead church. It wasn't even lukewarm. It was dead. And I got a chance to read that book over my sabbatical. And I said, man, this is what we're missing as a church. And I'm praying on how we can get together on prayer of agreements. They had a special night where they had prayer. And for them, it was Tuesday night. And all they did was come together and pray. Wasn't preaching, wasn't singing. On that Tuesday night, all they did was pray. And when they prayed, God began to open the doors or open that window of heaven. You hear me allude to as a path. There's a window here, but it's not open. God wants to open it up. He wants to pour souls in this place. He wants to pour blessings in this place. He wants to pour restoration in this place. He wants to pour forgiveness in this place. Oh, the window is here. But it's not open. Let's see what this prayer of agreement did in this text in Acts. Acts chapter 4, verse 23, the next slide. This is what happened. After they prayed, not after the preaching, not after the singing, not after the offering, after they prayed, the place where they were meeting was shaken. And they all were filled with the Holy Spirit and spoke the word of God boldly. After they prayed, the miracles came. After they prayed, the Holy Spirit came. After they prayed, then the preaching started. Yeah. That's why I say preach is a call to preach is a call to what?
Pray.
It's a call to pray. And they began to, after they prayed, then they began to share the word of God boldly after they prayed, after they prayed, after they prayed. They prayed together in agreement. They wanted to see God work and move in awesome and marvelous ways. And it didn't happen till after they prayed. Great spiritual work and move in your life will not happen until you learn to do level one of your concerns, level two of your concerns, level three of your concerns. After you learn how to cast your anxieties. Can anybody tell me what's the difference between anxieties and worry?
Anxieties is you just get ridden with it.
So anxieties, you're just guilt-ridden. Worries and concerns. So the concern is, you know, you're not really worried about it. Not anxious about it.
Right.
But it just concerns you. And all of that stuff, you've got to learn to give it over to the Lord. And I like the last part of this, and really this is probably level four, but I want to keep 3 points.
Yes, it had 3 points.
But it says, after that, it says, after that, all your anxieties, all your worries, all your concerns, and this part here, once and for all. Once and for all, remember, I told you at the beginning of the presentation, many of us preach treat prayer like we're fishing with a rod and reel. We cast it out to the Lord and go a long way. And then the anxieties of the day, worries of the day, the concerns of the day, reeling it all back in. No, that's not true prayer. True prayer throws it. Cuts the string.
Let it go.
And let it go. Some of you got to cut some strings on some folk and let them go.
Yeah.
Ooh, you got to cut some strings. They may have your last name. You still cut.
Amen.
Yeah.
It may be your brother-in-law, your father-in-law, your daughter-in-law. Cut some strings. Cut some strings. And the only way you really know how to do this, and I guess this is level five.
Cut the strings.
Is has to be on him, for he cares for you affectionately and cares about you watchfully. He cares for you. One of the greatest concepts for, I believe, this generation to understand, or any person who didn't have a good father or didn't grow up in the legacy of a good father, is that they will have the hardest of times coming to the concept that God cares for them. Because you get your image of God from your earthly dad. And many of us do, some don't, but many do. And the way your earth,
the calm on the sea. But what we need is a special word that will burn within our heart and give us direction from above.